Part 6 of Belize will take us to a little place in the southern part of Belize called Monkey River. We knew that the water was going to be high and expected the roads to be a little flooded, but at the end there's a great bar where you can relax before you take your eco tour up the river. We started our 10th day in Belize with a torrential downpour while on our way to a place in southern Belize called Monkey River. It's a great place to observe the ecosystem and the Belizean jungle river run. When the rain comes, you can see it approaching by a wall of rain heading your way. The rain came down steady for about an hour. I'm sure traveling the Monkey River will be a little challenging, but we'll get there. After a while, the rain started to let up, but now the roads were slippery, muddy, and full of potholes. We knew and expected to be in many showers, as this is the rainy season in Central America. Monkey River is about 60 miles from our hotel, but it's a beautiful drive through the lush green valleys and remote villages along the way. But after a while, and still 10 miles to go, we started running into some real slick road. Okay, we reached a point in the road that it seems to be flooded because of the high rains lately. I don't know, should we do it?
I think we should.
It'll take it. Let's go for it.
Let's do it.
But it seems the closer we got to the Caribbean and the Monkey River, the road was completely underwater for about 3 miles. At one point, the Jeep actually floated for a few feet until it got traction. That was about when the water was just a little over 2 feet deep. Get a little wet this time of year. Hopefully there's a road underneath here. And at this point we caught up with some other people making their way to the end of the river. They slowed us down a little, but we judged the depth of the water as we went along. If they made it, we would.
Riding down Monkey River.
Not sure how much of this Jeep can take. It's been running a little strange lately too. Monkey River is located just off to our right, about 50 feet through the jungle edge. Hey, finally, we made it.
We're located at the mouth of the Monkey River as it meets the Caribbean, and we're trying to get a boat ride to the other side.
I left the task of procuring a ride to the other side of the river to Phyllis. She'll find someone to float us over to Monkey River Town shortly, I'm sure.
Right now the tide is coming in, so the river is fighting against the sea, and that was the reason why the road was flooded back there.
It would appear that she has found us a ride to the other side of the river. Yes.
Probably had a cold beer before we head up river. dope, so we're just fine. Cheers. Okay, so we get this guy to take us upriver. Upriver to see what's going on for a while.
This looks
real touristy.
Yes, it does. And this guy was brought along to spot for floating debris and wildlife along the way. Due to the heavy rains lately, the river is high and has a lot of potential hazards hidden just below the surface. Everywhere you looked, the riverbank was covered with beautiful flora fauna and almost impossible to walk through.
Hear that? Yes. I can hear some howlers up there.
Yeah. Oh yeah.
And these are bird nests up in here?
Yeah, those are the yellow belly and brown bear.
The original bird nest is carpenter.
You look on the tree, you'll see a couple of them.
Oh yes, yes.
Yeah, you saw?
Yes.
That yellow and black.
And this is the crested Aurapendula.
Oh yes!
And along the way we passed another boat with some die-hard eco-tourists. The further we traveled upstream, the more obstacles we encountered. And this is Morillette's crocodile, Crocodilius morilletti, or known as the Mexican crocodile.
They hunt them?
No, people just come and watch them. No one really hunts them.
It's a modest-sized crocodilian found only in fresh waters of the Atlantic regions of Mexico, Belize, and Guatemala. And it's a least concerned species. Morillette's crocodile was discovered in Mexico in 1850 and named after the French naturalist who made the discovery. It was long confused with the American and Cuban crocodiles because of similar characteristics and ambiguous type locally. It was not generally accepted as a separate species until the 1920s. Now that was an interesting journey upriver. You may have noticed there were no life vests, oars, gas, or emergency equipment in the boat. That's not uncommon in other countries that we've traveled to. We worked up an appetite, yeah right, and was told there is a restaurant in the village. We found the restaurant and it was serving only one dish, and that dish was chicken, rice, beans, and Coke in a bottle. It was surprisingly delicious and reasonable. Now we have to drive back through the flooded roads and to Plasencia to our hotel. Tomorrow, we visit a banana plantation to see just how our bananas are grown and packed. See you tomorrow morning.
Well, for some reason, the vehicle wouldn't start. So we had to have a new one delivered. I don't know why it wouldn't start, but... this is our new vehicle, okay. Okay, now we find ourselves in a banana plantation. I guess each one of the banana heads needs to be wrapped. Breakfast. I tell you not to come in here because of the snakes and spiders. They're kind of rotted.
Oh, they are, all of them down there?
Sorry.
On the ground.
Phyllis wants to go shopping. Okay, here's your banana.
Okay, there's little ants all over it.
Don't mind the ants.
We went on the banana farm. You know, we get a real banana.
Not bad at all.
Oh, that's so sweet. It's delicious.
Yeah, it isn't bad.
But I told you to eat a banana.
I think we ought to go back and get more.
No, I'm pushing.
Don't push it, huh?
We're getting an exclusive tour of Fifi's banana plantation. But first, we have to watch a video on the process before we go out into the plantation. Fifi's bananas are sold exclusively to Europe, and they're not sold in any other country, including Belize. And this caravan of bananas is
gone.
Being pulled to the processing plant by one strong man. It seems these corridors just went on for miles.
You did?
Work all night and a drink of rum.
The very beginning of a bunch of bananas.
Well, that gets in there.
Actually, you can see the fingers or the hand forming underneath every rock.
Every one of them. Now,
and then, do you guys bear in mind all the pseudo stems on the spine of the leaf? They are all different. The pseudo stem. On the spine of them, global leaf, they are more greener than our common bananas.
This is the assembly line, where the bananas are pulled in from the plantation by human power with overhead rails. They enter the plant, get washed, sized, labeled, categorized, packed, and shipped. I was not allowed to video in the plant. Nevertheless, they had us wrap, pack, label, categorize, along with the rest of the workers.
We even got a little treat at the end of our tour. Banana slices, fried banana slices, and they're so good.
And it was amazing to see just how much faster they could do the task than we could.
We stopped at the side of the road on our tour to have a cold beer and a hamburger.
Daylight come and be one. 6 foot, 7 foot, 8 foot bunch. Daylight come and be one more.
21.50.
21.50.
$21.50, or that would be $10.75 for one hamburger, one cheeseburger, one iced tea, and a cold beer. That's not bad. Come, Mr. Tallyman.